And if you're a student of military history, you know that lives have been saved and lost, and that battles and wars have been won or lost based upon either bad, no, or late information. This is what DOD knows now. It's something that all of you guys take for granted. It's kind of your bedrock when it comes to data, that the movement, the access, and the use of data in near instantaneous ways is a commonplace. It's not for us. It will be. And that's the only way we know that in the future that our warfighters across the globe are going to win. We need to take your commercial solutions, and we need to integrate them into the military. We need to put them on a global scale in both an unclassified and classified environment. That information has to be available to the warfare on the tactical edge, not just the headquarters. It's got to be available anywhere, anytime. Everyone in this room knows that our nation has enjoyed military dominance for quite a long time. If we don't solve this, we won't keep that level of overmatch. Ladies and gentlemen, the information has to be available to an F-35 that's entering a hostile area where a new surface-to-air missile pops up. It has to be available to a submarine that's submerged to get new mission orders. It has to be available to an Army platoon that a friendly unit is just around the block and does not open fire. It's got to be available to a platoon of Marines that are about to breach a door that an IED has been found. It's got to be made available to our special forces that there's an ambush plot. The information has to be made available. Whichever one of you wins this, I'm challenging you to bring your A game. This is not an IT project. This is going to make a difference, like few things have, to get data to our warfighters when and where he or she needs it. It is not an IT contract. Is about ensuring that the women and men who fight our nation's war win, period. And if you're not prepared for that, you don't need to be here. That's what this is about.